God took care of Ruth and Naomi, so I know he'll take care of me and my homie.
Welcome everybody to the J Sadie Variety Show, and praise the Lord. Howdy y'all, I'm J Sadie Gray, and my sister Lenny is here with us. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Today we're talking about the old adage, many hands make light work. But first, here is Larry Cordell singing, God Had a Hand in It.
When you smell the roses on a springtime day, taste the salt from the touch of an ocean wave,
see a million stars light up the sky,
hear a little newborn baby cry,
God had a hand in it. My God had a hand in it. His master plan did it. It all began with it. There ain't no big bang about it. There may be those who doubt it. They just refuse to get it. God had a hand in it.
It only took 6 days and six nights work.
He created all the wonders of the universe.
It's just a mighty brush stroke and a flick of the wrist.
When you got the rainbow at your fingertips.
God had a hand in it. My God had a hand in it. His master plan did it. It all began with it. There ain't no big bang about it. There may be those who doubt it. They just refuse to get it. God had a hand in it.
From the great Grand Canyon to the Northern Lights,
Victoria Falls to Mount Everest
High, every miracle in this world confirms,
the master's touch is everywhere you turn.
God had a hand in it. My God had a hand in it. His master plan did it. It all began with it. There ain't no big bang about it. There may be those who doubt it. They just refuse to get it. God had a hand in it.
God had a hand in it.
My God had a hand in it. His master plan did it. It all began with it. There ain't no big bang about it. There may be those who doubt it. They just refuse to get it. God had a hand in it. God had a hand in it. My God had a hand in it.
You know, back in the day, they used to have a thing called barn raisins. This is where the whole community would come together and frame up a barn in a day. With the whole community, the job was finished easier and faster. This explains the old adage of many hands make light work. But can you imagine what could be done with just one set of hands? Your hands and the Lord's hands, our Heavenly Father's hands? Just by folding our hands in prayer, turning our concerns and cares to the Lord, miracles can be done. We love the book of Ruth, and in that book it tells us about two poor widows who lost everything. They decided to turn to the one true God, the God of Abraham, who became the father of faith and the father of nations, the God of Isaac, who was the promised miracle son of Sarah, and the God of Jacob, who became Israel, a man of faith. That same God led those widows by the hand each step of the way, and they went from not enough to just enough, then to more than enough. All this was done by the hand of God. So by putting things in God's hands, it becomes the lightest work of all. So if you need the ultimate helping hands, just pray this prayer with me. Dear Heavenly Father, please forgive me of my sins. I believe Jesus is your Son, and that he died on the cross and rose from the dead. Please take my hand and lead me the right way. In Jesus' name, amen. Now listen, if you believe in your heart this prayer, you're saved. And the best tip we could give you is to read your Bible daily so your faith will grow. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Well, it's time for another song. And here are the Freemen singing, Hold to God's Unchanging Hand.
Time is filled with swift transition. None of earth unmoved can stand. Build your hopes on things eternal and hold to God's unchanging hand. Trust in Him who will not leave you. Whatsoever years may bring, if by earthly friends forsaken, still more closely to Him cling.
Hold to His hand,
to God's unchanging
hand. Hold to His hand,
to God's unchanging hand. On things eternal and whole to God's unchanging hand. When your journey here has ended, if to God you have been true, fair and bright your home in glory, your enraptured soul will view. God's unchanging hand. Build your hopes on things eternal and hold to God's unchanging hand. Hold to God's unchanging hand.
This week's poem is by Deborah Ann, and its title is, My Times Are in Your Hands. My times are in your hands. My God, I wish them there. My life, my hopes, my every dream are completely in your care. My times are in your hands. I give them all to you. My days, my nights, my entire tomorrows are yours to do what you must do. My times are in your hands, and all that I do and say, my thoughts, my feelings, my deepest desires are yours to do what you may. My times are in your hands to mold as you seem right. My love, my faith, my total trust are yours to do as you might. My times are in your hands. Dear Lord, I want them there. My heart, my mind, my soul's design are yours to trim and pair. Deborah Ann was inspired to write that song, that poem, when she read Psalm 31:15, where it states, "My times are in thy hand." Well, we're about out of time. We thank you so much for listening. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Well, and we have you in our prayers. And if you have a prayer request, just send us a private message on Facebook or on our website, jsadiegray.com. And we're going to leave you now with the Rambos singing a golden oldie titled "The Unseen Hand." And oh, by the way, check out our monthly blog on our website, and have a blessed week.
Sun will reign. God bless you all in Jesus' name.